Educational content using blind and deaf communication app. I will make an introduction. I will talk about MOOC because this work is made is. Will start we make to implement in a MOOC the educative contents architecture for blind and deaf persons is the newest parameter in this paper and after the conclusion. So the constant need of for teachers to be professionally updated in knowledge areas and pedagogical approaches take needs of being updated in content. So my research group use MOOCs to prepare a post-graduation to teachers. This why in this specific MOOCs I will tell you why we prepare for teachers, but for teachers and students with special needs to will allow participation of deaf and blind people. Students or teachers also. So we think we are innovating in the educational field. So this paper presents the blind deaf communication API architecture, which translates digital educational contents for those persons. So a MOOC. Our MOOC, we have two post-graduations in ISEP, and our MOOC are being prepared for those two post-graduations in informatics for education and supporting for the other supporting technologies for education. So they are those MOOCs are for the people of education. To involve the multidisciplinary teams made up professionals with distinct trainings allows the construction of a balanced educational environment which foster an accessible, inclusive and innovative pedagogic environment. There was a special focus on the team to guarantee the active participation of all individuals in accordance with objectives previously set in the final plan. The cohesion and the compromise of the team will lead to a product totally adapted to a specific target. I don't know if you can see right the picture, but this is the team, all the team who works for the MOOC, and we have to coordinate, as we said before, we have to add teachers, we have to have coordinators of the unit of each unit. We have to have project management. We have to add computer team workers, design graphic team, investigators to make research, students, it's also an important part, and we have our provider to have our MOOC. Our provider is Udemy. We have chosen Udemy as provider. All these teams I have to work together and do well done job to make work the inclusive MOOC. This is the solution more specific. Our Udemy server, our database repository, and our kinetic gloves for preparing the gestual language for the deaf, our presentations. We have a lot of, in our laboratory, a lot of not gadgets, but specific yes, to prepare for normal students, we prepare PowerPoints, but for deaf and blind people, we have to transform the contents. So we have the MOOCs validate with the CAFE, so the evaluation framework will enable controlling the quality of the final product. It's a development process, and the architecture, I hope you can, the architecture for people with hearing impairment problems arise through the fact that deaf community uses its proper grammar in any writing language, meaning the majority are unable to read written text, so it's a difficulty we have to prepare to transform on a MOOC. It must also be noted that blind people rely on hearing cues to communicate, while deaf people rely on visual representation. So if we don't see, we use our ears, but if we don't hear, we use our eyes. They develop the other sense. If they don't have one, the other is more appeared. So these different channels prevent any type of communication between these two communities, meaning that the fair solutions must be drafted in each community. The architecture presented in Ulysse and all seeks to solve these communication problems, most particularly in area of education. So the technologies include, in here we use already IBM Watson voice recognition and text to speech, Google Wave Speech API, visual sign and 3D avatar performing sign language. Those softwares are used to transform the data that we want. So this is the architecture of our educational content. So all of this is the architecture, and we have the sign language avatar and the sign language grammar in a block. The voice recognition are input, and voice and sound are input to the avatar. Video, image, text, voice, sound are output to PowerPoint. Text to speech is output to PowerPoint, and PowerPoint to the online courses here on Udemy. Deaf people, do we have the sign language? We have already working the in Portuguese and English, already the MOOC prepared. For blind people, it's not already finished, because the avatar have to talk, and we only have on Portuguese, because the translation to English, we didn't finish the work, so we are only working for in Portuguese for blind people. So this paper represented the BCD API architecture applied to an interactive MOOC, translates the digital educational material for deaf and for the blind people who otherwise would be unable to have full access to these contents. Educational content on PowerPoint can be official Microsoft plugins that can call BCD API translation methods to translate automatically. The application use web speech API for voice recognition to allow the blind to interact with the machine, and the text to speech to give information and to generate sound in basic in the API. Regarding the deaf, making use of pure sign avatar and sign language grammar to make the translation so that the deaf can understand the content. Both cases allow bidirectional communication in any language, which could be used in classrooms. Thank you.